The father of one of the four men killed in Benghazi issues a challenge to Hillary Clinton. Charles Woods wants Clinton to take a lie detector test alongside him to determine who is lying about whether she told families that the attack was provoked by a YouTube video. One America's Neil W. McCabe has more in this exclusive interview.
Charles Woods, the father of Tyrone Woods, told One America News he has struggled to stay out of the politics surrounding Benghazi, where his son, a former Navy SEAL, and then a CIA security contractor, was killed. Woods said he felt compelled to speak out after Hillary Clinton denied she told him and other family members of the men killed at Benghazi that a YouTube video was responsible for the attacks.
Ty, he lived a life of integrity and courage. When he accepted that decision to go against the stand-down orders, he knew that there's a very high probability that he was signing his own death warrant. But what I need to think about is the legacy of my son and the legacy of my family as well. And I would love to sit down with Hillary Clinton, if she'd agreed to do it as well, and, you know, at the same table by the same operator, have a lie detector test. I have attempted to have the high road in this. And I think it's really unfortunate that she was on the news lately being interviewed by George Stephanopoulos, I believe, where she was asked that question. And she basically called me and the other family members liars.
But the family members, as you know, say you told them it was by a filmmaker, you'd go after the filmmaker. Did you tell them it was about the film, and what's your response?
I said very clearly, there had been a terrorist group that had taken responsibility on Facebook.
This is how Woods recalled his conversation for the One American News special report, Betrayal at Benghazi.
She said, we're going to have that person responsible for the video put in jail. And it struck me as being very, very strange. Is this how you comfort someone? And that was the first time I'd heard about the video. I think there might have been something about a video in Egypt, but this was the first time I'd ever heard about a video. Aaron, why are you mentioning this? And just as an attorney that judges credibility, I knew that she was not telling the truth to me.
The retired judge said it is not just his account that contradicts Hillary Clinton's.
There's been four different family members representing three of the families that were victims. And they all said basically the same thing, that she blamed the attack on the video.
In less than a month, the voters take control of the campaign for president away from the candidates and away from the media. So far, Clinton has dodged congressional committees. But can she dodge the Benghazi families and the voters as well? Neil W. McCabe, One America News, Washington.